Right around when the 19th Amendment was passed to give women the rights to vote, the Harlem Renaissance happened. It was an explosion of African American culture, society, and art. The Great Migration was a highlight, which African Americans migrated from rural to urban spaces and from south to north. The great developments during the Harlem Renaissance helped fuel the civil rights movement.
As blues was moving away from the South to escape the Jim Crow laws, thousands of African American farm workers migrated north to Chicago and Detroit. Many wanted to hear the blues music that reflected their new urban surroundings. Jazz was started as blues delivered from African American music form. It expressed pain of lost love and injustice and gave expression to victory. Mammy Smith's recording of Crazy Blues is thought to be the first huge hit in jazz music. The song sold over a million copies in less than half a year. Right away, big labels like Columbia and Paramount began to approach on immigrant songs and brought black music to the center stage of American culture. Further investigation in jazz explains how musicians were affected during the civil rights era and created an impact to the American society.
Jazz is known to be one of the products of the Harlem Renaissance. The rich skill and improvisation delivered by African American jazz performers was breathtaking and gave an opportunity for the white and black race to share the same moment. But there were a few key figures who really made jazz an impact in the civil rights movement and changed history for the better. Louis Armstrong is the most well-known figure in jazz history. Armstrong was known to be one of the key figures to spread jazz nationwide. For a little background knowledge, Armstrong was born in the poor area of New Orleans on August 4th, 1901. During his time playing jazz, a new form was invented called swing. The optimistic feeling of swing lifted everyone's spirits and was the first style of jazz that appeared during the Great Depression. This resulted in this time being called the swing era. Armstrong kept silent about politics and the civil rights movement right up till the Little Rock 9 incident, when he said, "The way they are treating my people in the South, the government can go to hell." He received criticism at the time from both black and white public figures. Not a single jazz musician who had previously criticized him took his side. Today, this is seen as one of the bravest, most definitive moments of Armstrong's life.
John Coltrane was born on September 23, 1926 in Hammett, North Carolina. He is known to be the person who revolutionized jazz with his technically marvelous and innovative playing, becoming an iconic figure of jazz during the 20th century. Coltrane's Alabama was a response to the 1963 Birmingham church bombing that killed four girls. The song spoke to many people involved in the civil rights movement. The song begins with a sad tone representing Coltrane's feelings on the bombing at Birmingham, and gives his opinion and thoughts throughout the rest of the song. Lord have mercy on this land of mine. Born on February 21st, 1933 in Tryon, North Carolina, Nina Simone studied classical piano at the Juilliard School in New York City. She also was a civil rights activist known for performing Mississippi Goddam in front of a white audience, storytelling racial inequality in the South. Simone includes phrases such as, "All I want is equality," and "School children sitting in jail," to promote her response to racial discrimination. A change in atmosphere during the performance tells the effectiveness the song gave during the performance.
The name of this tune is Mississippi Goddamn.
One of the leading activist organizations, CORE, began to realize the potential of jazz music and organized two beneficial shows at Five Spot Cafe, attracting many people supporting civil rights groups such as the NAACP and the SNCC.
Jazz had an amazing impact on civil rights movement and the view on segregation of blacks and whites. Several people had been involved using jazz to make the world a better place. Jazz was one reason why people came together during the toughest times of the Great Depression. It is safe to say that Louis Armstrong, John Coltrane, and Nina Simone were the key figures of jazz that led to a great impact on civil rights movement and segregation.